before I apply the colors on her skin tone, I would like to ask the warm color around her eyes, her nose, her lip, and the cheekbones, right? So do that. I use a little bit of liquid, and I add a little bit of magenta here. And a little bit of cadmium red. Don't forget to wash your brush, okay? And then add a very thin layer. I'm start with the eyes, okay? On top of the eyelid, the lower lid, the corners of the eyes. See that? I'm gonna use my brush to blend them out a little bit. Just outside the eye, not inside the iris, okay? Just on top, lower lid, corners of the eyes, upper lid, around the eyes, like this, okay? We do the same thing for this eyes. You can also use your finger to blend. Like that. Top of the nose. Or you can also use paper towel. You know, you just have a little bit of it. Just plus a little bit of warmness in it. In the end, it's not the loss of red gonna show on your painting, but it's good for the start. Lips. Should have been one lip. And some cheekbone, okay? Just like you, again, just like we do some makeup for her. If you pay attention to the values, it does make the value changing a little bit, okay? When you ask the warmness, it seem that part seem a little bit darker. So you see, like that. Before I gonna do my inside palette one more time, I would like to work in on the backgrounds a little bit so I can control the color in the backgrounds and color inside, outside. I work inside, outside, inside, all the work all of them together at once, okay? Where's my brush? So I'm looking at this, I want it kind of bluish, grayish. So I'm gonna use a little bit of liquid here. Put it right here. So some black. Maybe a little bit more of the black. A little bit of blue. Ultramarine blue. Got a deep blue right now. Just a little bit of white to see how it goes. I like this color. It's kind of nice, but I want them more darker. And to make it a little bit warmer, I add a little bit of burn umber to make a little bit warmer. I don't want a blue, too blue. A little bit of black. So it's kind of gray. Now I can add a little more of white. You see, turn the blue, grayish, maybe a little bit of this blue. I can test, I can see how it's going. It's a nice grayish blue, I like it. It's not the final color for my background, but I want something kind of cool color. Then I make decision of the background later, okay? Just for now, I just like some color around this. So time for us to clean up the palette. I'm gonna mix the inside palette again. As the last episode, I was showing you how to mix the inside palette. Now we're gonna do this over again, okay? So please follow me. First, I start with burnt sienna. Oh, some of the liquid is in it. And this state, I'm still using liquid. In the next state, you're gonna maybe use an oil. But now, I want it dry fast, so I can move on to the next state. A little bit of liquid. Then, use the lavender. You need to do some exercise of mixing these colors, okay? I'm gonna use up the my oil dry now, so a little bit of the navel yellow. Okay, have a little bit of white. I'm gonna mix some of the shadow. Sap green. This is the yellow ochre. I need to put some yellow ochre in here in case I need it for her forehead. Time for me to make some of the highlight. I just use a little bit of lavender, a little bit of navy yellow, and some of the liquid here, a little bit of white. So now I'm ready. Let's do some tests on the nose, okay? It's really nice in here. This is the first layer of the color, so I'm not really pay attention to a lot of details. Try to guess the color and the values first. I like the warmness of the nose and I'm testing it. Here is the top of the nose here. I'm saving the highlight here. Okay, and see how it's go. The brush I'm using is the round brush from Brink System, number 0. But you can use something a little bit bigger, okay? If you want to. In the shadow areas, I can use this part is Burnt Sienna. Some sap green and then mix a little bit of the lavender colors. And I'm gonna do a very thin layers of it on top of the side. When you paint in the shadow areas, you should paint them very thin. When you paint in the highlights, you can paint very thick. Not very thick, but you can do it thicker. Again, it's your choice. Painting thick or painting thin, apply a lot of oil paint or less oil paint is your style, okay? No rule for it. Some people they like to paint very, very thick, like Rembrandt, it's totally fine. People would love to do that. Some people paint very thin. If you see work by Bogoro, he paints very thin. Some of the painting, it seems like he doesn't even have the underpainting. You see, I'm working on the form of the nose. Always think about values, think about shape and form, okay? You can do translucent, the skin tone on top of the green. Creates a beautiful colors right in here. Some people ask me, what if you don't use the underpainting? You don't use the green Vedaccio, how it look like? I think it look fine, but maybe it might look less realistic. But it could be fine. I have seen artists painting without it. And some of them painted very well, look very good too. So this is the, I wouldn't say this is the only way to paint skin tone. There are many ways. And as an artist, as a teacher, I studied with many artists, and some people are using that technique, some people don't. But I like you to try it. If you like it, you can use them for your own work. If you don't, you don't have to, okay? It's nothing is wrong or right. It just depends on how you feel about it. Some people are comfortable with the technique because they're patient. Some want to be painted right away, have the good result right away. So it's different. Back some. For now, you can see it start look like skin tone now. Let it there. I'm gonna move on to her eyes maybe. Let's just be darker here a little bit. A little bit of Muchoma green in the shadow areas to make them a little bit cooler and a little bit darker. People ask me a lot about why I like to paint. I start with the nose, and again, before I just think I paint it because it's I'm comfortable with it. But now I think one of my students was give me an answer, and it makes sense to me that my sisei could be because it's the center of the face. It's making easy for me to control the rest of it. It could be, but when I started, I don't even pay attention. Just know that I like to start with the nose, and the nose is when I have the nose established, certain things seem easy for me to move around. But maybe you see we're right. But you can start with the eyes, or you can start with. The forehead is no rules here, okay? The first painting layer now. I like this part a little bit lighter. You see I'm using this wrench in here, right? Shadow mid-tone highlight. Should add some of this in here. Like a little highlight on her nose a little bit stronger, so I can control the rest of the values of the face. It's not the final detail, but at least it gives me like a guideline that I know that the nose is where strong highlights here. Okay, so I can follow that guideline to continue to work on the rest of the face. So be a little bit stronger. Maybe some white. Using this. Unless the nose stay there, time for me to work on the eyes and go to the forehead. Very similar concept, okay? Around the eyes, I'm going to add a little bit more of this mixture here of the magentas and the cadmium red. With a little bit of this combination here in this corner. So it's a little bit warmer. Testing it. To pink. I'm going to add a little bit more of the burnt sienna. the upper lid a little bit warmer. Okay, so. And go back to details of the eyes later. I want to build the values around it first. This is saffron, burnt sienna, mixed with the lavender, a little bit of yellow ochre. So we have, let's test it on here. Oops, sorry. Colors in it. You have to clean your brush all the time, okay? You see that I have a mistake in here. Let's remove it. See, I'm softening all the edges here, and it's just the first layer. Then I will add more details later on, but for now I like this soft. number, ultramarine. Make them a little bit darker in here. So I'm working on the shadow areas here. The harder part is the transition from shadow to highlight. In this case, you can the shadow here, do the form shadow and the tone into the mid-tone, and then some highlights on top of it. So this shadow should be very soft, okay? It's just bone sienna. Add a little bit of saffron again, make them a little bit darker. And from here, you see that greenish color here. I want it warmer in this side when I go to the cheekbone. And I can add a little bit of this color here. To make sure that part is dark, so I can make the transition from the shadow here to the skin tone. And I will use a little bit more of Uchama Green, has a little bit of Bone Sienna, Bone Umber, Sap Green, a little bit of the magenta here. So it become kind of dark color. But it's not black. I'm gonna work in the brightest color here, shadow here. What I'm doing is just try to get the transition better. Sometimes we have to call wet on wet because you want the edges. The oil is still wet, so you can make the softness better. So now I can use a little bit of burnt sienna, a little bit of yellow ochre. Then I'm gonna go on top of this. So I can make the ad look more convincing. My brush, blacks again, not black, but dark shadow. It's hard to see the edges, okay? So I'd like you to pay attention to it. You can see now the transition is much smoother. It looks more convincing. Gonna do exactly the same from here to here, and the next step gonna be detail. But hanging in there, patient, okay. Sometimes do a demo like this will take a long time, and I know that I need to edit the video so it's not too boring. But I'd like you to see what I'm doing here. The important everything I do is important for you to see, so I'm trying not to cut out too much details of the video. add some warm colors in the lip for now. So it doesn't look odd. I will go back for detail later on. From this part, I'm pretty happy with the first layer. I need them to dry off a little bit so I can work on detail. But now I'm gonna continue to work on her chest And but before that, I want to add some colors in the hair, okay? She have a brown hair. Kind of clean up the brush. Use green, soft green, and burnt sienna. Has a little bit of liquid. And see how it's work. Okay, it's not the final detail, but I'm glad there's some colors in it. It's easy for me to work. And I see a little bit of yellow ochre on her hair. I think it's very, very beautiful. I'm gonna add it on. Yellow ochre, more green. Just some color for now. I will add more detail, but I want a little bit of color so I can control the value actually. Again, it's a burnt sienna. The shadow adds a little bit of ultramarine to make them darker in the shadow here. Soft the edges. Green, a little bit of yellow ochre. A little bit of ultramarine in this combination here to make a shadow again. You see, I barely use black. I will, but at this point I try to avoid it. Two color I don't use direct is black and white. I think it's a very hard color to work with, and I have to be careful when I'm using those colors. See? Alright, add a little bit of colors up. A scarf, got the salmon colors. I think it should be red. A little bit of burnt sienna, the cadmium red. Some of the yellow ochre. Just tiny of magenta here. A little bit of white. See, wow. And here you got the colors are very similar. I'm a little bit darker with burnt sienna. A little bit soft. That's magenta. So I have got a similar color here, but I just for some in it. I have people ask me that how come as I most of my the model is I'm working with, they wear the scarf. Actually, it's just the model when they come to my studios, and I always ask them if they can, you know, they have something to bring with them, and if they want to wear something, and they put it on, and I think it's beautiful, and I painted it. I don't have any idea. It have to be, you know, so. But I think woman with the scarf look kind of beautiful too. It's just my opinion about it. So now I know that this nicer if the background a little bit darker up here, but I wouldn't worry about it that much at the point. I will work on it on a different stage. Okay, now continue work on the hair. More bone sienna. Be a little bit yellow ochre. So. Magenta to make the hair a little bit warmer. More colors in here. I like color. I'm not afraid of using color. So I think you should do the same thing. Don't be afraid of colors. So I'm almost done with this stage. I will let the painting dry off tonight, and tomorrow I will continue to work on the details. Have more details and I know lips and pop her out. Dark brows should be a little bit darker. Her skin should be a little bit lighter. So I cannot do much today because it's stupidly wet. I can't lazing it.